The Federal Elections Commission has been, I guess, investigating Marjorie Taylor Greene for almost 3 full years now. A formal complaint was leveled with the FEC in May of 2021. And here we are in the first week of January 2024. And the FEC finally, after years of investigating, said, yes, Marjorie Taylor Greene broke the law in the year 2020 by appearing in an ad for a soft money super PAC that can, of course, receive unlimited campaign contributions. And the FEC said, we are going to fine Marjorie Taylor Greene thousands of dollars for this illegal activity. Now, before you pop the champagne corks here, let me explain to you what's really happening. Back in 2020, when Marjorie Taylor Greene was a candidate for a federal office, she was not an office holder yet, but she was in fact a candidate for a federal office. She did an ad for this super PAC called Stop Socialism. And in the ad, she said, imagine Biden and Harris in the White House, Pelosi Speaker, Schumer runs the Senate, all because Georgia lost her 2 Senate runoff seats to Democrats John Ossoff and Raphael Warnock. Stop socialism now, PAC. We'll stop Ossoff and Warnock from stealing our Senate seats. It's time to fight back now before it's too late. And then she said, give your money, give $5,000, $2,000. She listed off a bunch of numbers, but it did start with $5,000. So, because she was a candidate for federal office, federal law bars her from appearing or from soliciting funds for a group that doesn't have limits on how much money they can raise. It's a weird, weird thing, right? Like, if the group had had limits, like if it was set up as a different type of political action committee and there were limits to how much people could give, this ad would not be illegal. But because these were unlimited, the law says, nope, a federal candidate or office holder cannot do that. Again, super confusing, super weird, and let's be honest, super stupid, because there should be no coordination at all. Like, that shouldn't be a thing that's allowed. But as I said, she got fined thousands of dollars, right? Well, Marjorie Taylor Greene, who has a net worth into the millions, was fined $12,000. $12,000. Now, I don't know if she has to personally pay that out of her bank account or if she's allowed to use money from, you know, her own groups that she runs or her campaign funds. Either way, $12,000 is not something that Marjorie Taylor Greene is going to end up noticing. The FEC determined she broke the law. It's not even like this was like a minor ethics blip. They said what you did was illegal. You broke the law. Give us $12,000 and then we're good. That's why these people do it. Just like the stock trading. They trade the stocks because you know what happens if a member of Congress gets busted violating the Stock Act? They pay a fine of $250. Not $250,000, $250. That's it. You make tens of thousands of dollars off your stock trades, but if you get caught, you have to give us back $250. So hell yeah, they do it. If the penalty for a crime is a fine, then that law only applies to the lower classes. And that is exactly what we're looking at with Marjorie Taylor Greene. $12,000 fine right now is going to break me. It's going to break most of the people watching this video. But for somebody like Marjorie Taylor Greene, whatever. Here's your money. Just the cost of doing business, right? Ring of Fire is just a few subscribers short of hitting that 1 million subscriber milestone. So if you're not already subscribed, please go ahead and do so and stay up to date with all of the latest from Ring of Fire.